All you do is get in and sit down. Not one of you pay attention and look underneath, see if the chair had all its legs. You throw yourself down and you have this confidence and this trust that this chair can hold you up. And so, you just sit down. It amazed me how we could put our trust and our confidence in a chair. And we can't put it in the God who made the material that the chair is made from. But we can put in our confidence and our trust in a chair. But the God who made the material that the chair is made from, we have problems trusting him. Hallelujah. Bless us today, Lord. We got some place. We got some place today. The psalmist put it this way. In Psalm 118 and 5, the writer said, I what? Call upon the Lord and what? In distress, the Lord what?
Answer me
and do what? Set me well in a large place. We can't trust this person who will answer us in our distress, not only answer us in our distress, but will set us up in a large place. I just go to what the next verse is. I got run. I'm here all day. The Lord is what? Let's go. Let's voice it up here. The Lord is
on my side. I'm
not failing. It's not doing me. All right, and voice number 7.
The
Lord is taking my soul. You can look up in the corner of that piece. In the pen and soul is mine. The Lord, the what?
Taking my path
with them and help me. Therefore, I shall
see my desire.
On the wicked. And then we go to voice 8, where the thief come from.
It is
better to trust in who?
In the Lord.
And to put our confidence in who?
In
and so I want to say again, I want to announce it again, stop putting your trust in man. When I was a little boy, I am over 60 years old now, when I had sense, my grandmother that used to say, the ounce of flesh will fail. So don't change. It doesn't change. Stop putting your trust in man. You know, the Hindus, we like to put our trust in the politician. And we believe what the politician say more than what God says. They are humans like you. They will tell you what they want to tell you to get your attention and your vote. When it's over, it's a different story. But if you put your trust in God, everything is going to be all right. We stopped last week. We saw at Job 13 and 15. 13 and 15. I jumped down and God said, we stopped us because Job put it this way. Job, he said,
yeah,
I can trust him. But Job was saying, no matter how bad he treats me, I still trust him because I know he knows where I am, who I am, and what I am doing, and he will bring me out. All right, let's look at it this way. Let's go there. Job, oh, Jesus, have faith. Job 23 and 10. I had that in the program. Job 23 and 10. Let's go there. Let me see if I can go there and put this in. That was in it. Job, look what Job says. What?
He knows the way that I have taken.
Many have tried me, but I'm what? I shall come forth as what?
Gold.
Oh, Lord, help them today. Voice number eight. Voice number eight. Let me take it. Listen what Job said in a happy death to voice 10, but listen what he said in voice number 8. Behold, I go forward. And what happened?
He is not there.
Huh? I go forward and he is what? Not there. I go backward and what?
I cannot perceive him.
Voice number 9. On the left hand, there he doeth good, but I cannot. He hided himself in the right hand that I. And then he dropped the voice number 10. But Job is saying, you wouldn't pick up on it. You see how Job picked up his trust? Listen, I go backward, I ain't see him. I go forward, I ain't see him. I go on the right, I can't find him. I go to the left, I can't find him. Then Job said, listen, I don't know where he is at this moment, but he knows the way that I am taken. And when he is traveling, I shall come forth as Job told. But Job is saying, I don't see him, I hear him, but I'm still trusting him. Because he knows the way that I am taken.
Hallelujah.
How many times we call and he didn't answer when we wanted him? How many times have we seek for him and it feel like he was not?
My God.
But Job said, all of that, I beg and trust him because he knows the way I have taken. When he have tried me, I shall come forth. And it tells us time and time again, we need to trust in God. You need to trust in God. And of the promises that comes along with him. With him. Job said, what's the promise? Job said, listen, I can trust him. Because he knows where I'm going. He knows what I'm going through. He knows what I, oh Lord, help me to do. The reason why I gotta trust him because he knows what lies ahead. He's the only one knows what lies ahead.
Yes,
sir. So I gotta trust him. Put my trust because he knows what all of us are hoping to see tomorrow. But he already knows who will see tomorrow. He already knows the time that the sun will rise and tide will flow. And what accident will happen and who he will protect. So that's why I'm gonna trust him. Psalms 5, the fifth division of the Psalms, verse 11 to 12. Fifth division of Psalms, but let all those that put there and be do what? Huh? All them that put their trust in God, what you should do?
Rejoice.
What else he said? Let them what? I mean, but let the what? Ever shout with joy, because thou defendest them. Let them also that love thy name be. I think last week I talked about my kids when they were small, when Daddy was old. It felt good. Daddy, when you come in, bring death. Daddy, sometimes, Daddy, when you come and bring shrimp fried rice. Daddy, when you come and bring Kentucky. Mommy, you go bring it. And they have that confidence. They hang up the phone. And far as they're concerned, when Daddy comes home,
done.
Everything's straight. But great life will tell them to put the trust in mind. And have this confidence that things are going to be all right. What would you and I? Huh? What would you and I? Man, you know, the I believe some of you born too good and you don't know, you know, and I tell you Sunday, God sing the song in the 70s, say you gotta have some rain in your life to appreciate the sunshine. You don't know what it is to be up if you never was down. Every time you open your cupboard, food was always in there, and everything was hard, and all your bill was paid, and rough time come. You know, most of the people that commit suicide in the United States from rich family. But 75% of the people, young children that commit suicide are from rich family. You know why? When they born, daddy them used to buy and give to them. And then all of a sudden the market crashed and daddy can't do it no more. 5 days concerned their life is over. I heard Dr. Miles Monroe talk about his friend who lost $57 million in 15 minutes on the stock market. $50-something million in 15 minutes. One bad investment and the market crash. And he had to move out of his townhouse back into his one bedroom house in his bed. That is any crazy. But for those of us who came up, oh Lord, make sure you see the same. We came up the hard way. Then we made it up. We finally made it in his mouth. Huh? We went to school with him. Oh! In our shoes. We didn't have much, but the Lord! Lord, I can testify now. I've been there! Where I had to, when school closed in June, I had to hang up the pants I had for September. Right now, the time school closes here on Monday, I gotta go buy a uniform. Hey, I gotta go buy a uniform. No! I come from a place where you have to hang it up! For September, I've been there. See, the Lord brought us through. There were times I saw my grandmother go Prince and Joshua later and say, son, this all I need. But we dreamt the day it happened. And thankful. That's why I'm over 60 years and I can look back and say, I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I'm gonna trust in the Lord. I've seen it.